हेलो वनीदा, कैन यू हियर मी? आई कैन लिप रीड दैट यू कैन हियर मी, बट आई कांट मेक आउट दैट यूर लाइक वी कांट हियर यू एट ऑल. सो एज वनीदा हैज सेंड मी अ मैसेज. शी हैज अपोलोजाइज एंड शी सेड दैट इन केस शी इज नॉट एबल टू कंटिन्यू इन द सेशन शी विल डेफिनेटली जॉइन अस इन आर नेक्स्ट वेबिनार. राइट, एंड विद दिस आई थिंक वी कमिंग टू द क्लोज ऑफ दिस सेशन. इट वॉज वंडरफुल हैविंग ऑल ऑफ यू हियर. Before we go towards the vote of thanks, I request all of you to kindly enable your cameras and let's have a quick photograph, a group photograph over here. I request all the participants to kindly enable your cameras so that we can see you and we'll have a nice photograph. We have Fahim sir who's ready with to take screenshots. We are still having some people are still turning on the cameras. We'll just take a pause. We'll wait for a moment until everybody is on with the cameras. Yes, majority of us are having our cameras on. Thank you so much. Thank you so much for responding so well and so quickly. All right, Fahim sir, I think we're good to go. You can go ahead and kindly start clicking our pictures. We can do anything. Fine sir, unmute please. Fine sir, please inform us once you're done with the photograph clicking. We are all waiting. Chat, chat. Sir, I think we've clicked the photograph. Right, Fine sir? Fine sir, can you hear me?
Yes.
All right. We're done with the photograph?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
All right. Thank you so much, Fine sir. With this, we are coming to the close. And before that, if there are any specific questions, because we've got such wonderfully read people on the group here on this webinar. If you have any more questions, I think we can take questions if we, I'm sure, Kamat sir, Ripunja Sena sir, Hani Flakarawala sir, Rebecca herself, and Vanida, if possible, all are ready to and more than willing to answer. If you have any questions, please use your chat box. And within the next 10 minutes, we'll be winding up this session. So if you have any questions specific to a particular speaker, please mention the speaker's name as well. Chat has been enabled. If you have any questions, please feel free to send it on the chatbot and keep your microphones muted. Anwar sir, if you would like to add some inputs.
No. Yeah. Try to get Vanita also.
So we are trying, sir. She's got some problem with her headphones. She's got a computer. She is not using a laptop. She's using a computer. So she has to compulsorily use headphones, which are somehow not compatible.
Fahim sir from Bangkok also.
Fahim sir from Bangkok.
Yeah.
Can you please unmute him?
Yeah, Mohammed Fahim is online.
Yes, sir. I am online now.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, sir. We can hear you. So,
first of all, I am very happy to be part of this as a participant. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can hear you.
Yes, and all the speakers who given the speech, and some of, I think two are from Thailand. I know one of them, Achan Panida, but unfortunately she could not connect to given his insightful information to us. And I think it is a very good initiative taken by the Pune College on this particular virtual world. And I think we as a human, because it is, of course, is a natural phenomena, and a lot of challenge before us, particularly the economic front. So I think I very much appreciate and congratulation to the Anwar sir to initiate such kind of the forum where we can exchange our view, because I can see the various expertise from various places, from various countries. Particularly when I listened the first speaker from Rungsit University. Personally, I don't know her, but I know her friend. and his suggestion and is very useful. And I think after we have to pray actually to finish this COVID situation, and after that whatever challenge come there, so we need all the expert views from every global everywhere whoever can be contribute. And the biggest challenge, of course, in economic front, and as I know that some of speakers show about the poverty and employment job losses, so we have to think. And I think one thing also I would like to mention from this forum is that the role of universities is very important, because they can be discuss all this matter and make into the as a social movement from as I mentioned about, someone is mentioned about the local level act. So that is a very important thing that we can be cope with this COVID challenges, particularly the economic front. And I think overall it is a very good session indeed, and I'm very much happy to be part of that. And unfortunately we could not listen the Thailand perspective from the Dr. Vanida. I think she given some input, I am sure about that. But we know that as my experience is here, because I am working here in Thailand, and Thailand is also affected from COVID, but the way we move, that is a cooperation of the people, and of course we have to take the precaution for this global pandemic. So this is from my side, and I wish you all to stay safe and healthy, and pray for early go out from this COVID situation, and we go for another world. I think this is another kind of world we will see after the COVID pandemic. So it is very challenging, I can say. So it is a responsibility of the all academy here to be work together, and whatever their expertise and research to be shared to each other, so we can be cope the challenges of the future. Thank you.
Adil sir, we have Alam sir also, Mumtaz Alam sir from Fiji. Fiji. He's from Fiji.
Yes, sir. Mumtaz Alam sir. Mumtaz Alam sir.
Everyone.
Hello, Dr. Mumtaz Alam.
Hi, everyone. Yeah, first of all, I want to congratulate the Pune College team for arranging this type of seminar. Now you all aware that the world is facing a catastrophe, and the living hundreds and thousands, perhaps millions of people at the risk, and even the many capitalist countries also facing the problems, and very big countries like America is also facing the severe problem. And in this situation, the capitalism is actually utterly failed to deal with the coronavirus crisis. And in that time, we are doing a very good job. The College of Pune College is doing very good job. And I especially thanks to Dr. Anwar Sheikh, Professor Anwar Sheikh. We met 3 or 4 years earlier to the in Fiji Island when he and his friends came here to open the one Commonwealth University in Tonga. So we know each other from that time. And when I got the invitation to attend this seminar on the Facebook, I saw on the Facebook, then I thought, oh, this is arranged by the Professor Anwar Sir. It could be very good for me to attend. Then, and I hope even the this seminar is very good, although the Thailand perspective is not recent. And Fiji is very a small country. I think many of you not aware about Fiji, but only here the 18 case was here, but now the 12 case recovered, only 6 cases here. So the big country is facing the big problems. Now the small country like Fiji and the other small countries in Pacific Islands also, they are not facing the main problems. So this is the actually mainly the capitalist country facing this coronavirus problems, and the poor people also facing this problem. So this is my view from the Fiji, and I hope College of Pune College will arrange some this type of seminar in future. And if you will get invitation from the Pune College, we are ready to contribute in any seminar when you people will going to organize. Just remember us. And once again, I want to thank everyone, every participants. One of my friends, Fahim, is also from Thailand. We are from same university. Okay. Thank you,
Dr. Mumtaz Alam. Thank you so much. We also have Dr. Mustafa Momin, who is from Kuwait. Dr. Mustafa Momin?
Am I audible? Can you all hear me?
Yes, doctor, we can hear you.
Perfect. Thank you very much for this excellent session. The choice of speakers was fantastic. We got to know different perspectives on such important concepts related to the ongoing situation. Right from the beginning, right from the first speaker, in fact, this was a fantastic assortment of experts who shared their perspectives on this important issue. This is typical of Pune College. I noticed that all the activities that the team does, they are managed extremely well, and they are really good at choosing the topics, the speaking resources, and I have been benefiting from their learning events for a long time now. I thank you very much, Dr. Imran, for this opportunity, for making this possible for me to attend this session. I look forward to more such learning events. A special word of congratulations to all the speakers. You added excellent insights to this topic. We look forward to hearing you again in some other events too. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much, sir. And I think we should proceed towards the proposing of word of thanks.
Any more participants? Anybody? Any question, sir?
Any participants? Any other question that you have, we can still address that. I request all of you to kindly mute your mic.
Sonali Sinha is there.
Sonali Sinha, want to speak?
Yes, please, Sonali madam, please go ahead.
Good afternoon, everyone. I'm speaking from Turkey. It's a late moment that I realized that I should attend this conference. And I'm really thankful to the organizing team. And in this COVID moment, when everybody is so grossed with a lot of other activities, but staying at home, giving an opportunity for us to be more close to our family members. But still, we are all coined together through the use of Zoom. So the IT is working here. We were always cursing IT that IT never helps us in most of the cases. It's taken in a negative way. But here you can see it's also a positive way. We are all connected from different parts of the world and at the same time. I was listening. I missed out the first part of the conference because there was some technical problem. I could not listen to those speakers, but later on, after 40 minutes, I could join it. Thanks to Imran, Dr. Imran, for joining me at that moment. And also, I want to say something like, I was hearing some of the speakers speaking about the Indian government and about the employment, GDP and everything. I myself is an economics person. So what I was thinking, what was my view is, at present, the government, if you look into the WHO report, it says that India is having the highest population after China, but still it is having the lowest when you look into the percentage of people that are being affected due to coronavirus. And we are still stuck to that cluster of cases rather than having community transmission. Thank God that we didn't go to the stage three. And that is all because of Mr. Modi, who has taken a drastic action of lockdown at this correct moment. I'm staying in Turkey. Here, the situation has gone to community transmission, stage three. Because in the beginning, they left it very free, like it happened in Italy, Germany, and also in US. So now everybody is praising, actually, sitting outside. They are all praising Mr. Modi. So the situation is such that now the government is giving more importance to the people, those who are not listening and entering into this purposely, like calling, ajao, ajao, mere paas ajao, the disease. And people are not listening to the directions given by WHO or by the police person or by the doctors, or you can see by the government itself. So the short term, measures taken by the government is actually correct, because first we have to control the infection, then you can do the operations. Like when you get sick, you have to first stop bleeding or get the infection out of the country, and then you can think about employment, income, and other things. Now the government is fighting. We have a huge population to control, and the government is fighting for that. So I think so. Maybe after this is totally controlled, the government will definitely take care of the other, like employment, about the income, and other things. I think so. That much only I have to add up to this, what I heard from you all. And thank you for giving me an opportunity to speak. I really appreciate that. I learned a lot from this conference. It was a good insight for my learning. Thank you.
Yes, Fazil sir.
Would you want to say something, sir, or should I continue? Sir. Okay. Anwar sir.
Yes, any question other than India?
Anybody from Thailand, Germany, Nigeria, Kuwait, Ukraine, UK, Oman, Fiji, Australia? Any questions?
Okay, then no issue.
All right, sir. So we will move towards the vote of thanks. Request Akbar Sayed sir to kindly propose the vote of thanks. And after that,
thank you, Fazil, the national anthem. Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you're audible.
Yeah, thank you. Good evening to one and all. It's indeed my privilege to propose a vote of thanks in this evening. I, Akbar Sayed, on behalf of Yatim Khana and Madarsa, Anjuman Khairul Islam Pune College, IQSC team, Department of Commerce, PG and Research Center, Department of BBSCA, Principal, Teaching Faculty, and on my own behalf, extend a very hearty thanks to all the keynote speaker, to specific Dr. Rebecca Webb for gracing this occasion and sharing us her knowledge with us. I'm thankful to our honorable trustee, Yatim Khana and Madarsa Anjuman Khairul Islam, Dr. Hanif Lakdawala sir, for sharing his knowledge with us. I'm also thankful to Professor Dr. Ripu Ranjan Sinha sir for presiding this session and giving the insights about COVID-19. A big thank you to you, sir. A big thank to Dr. Manoj Kamath sir for his keynote address mentioning various remedies to boost economy. And I'm also thankful to Professor Dr. Vanida ma'am, as there is a technical issue, but she tried his from her side. Thank you very much, ma'am. I'm thankful for the feedback from Muhammad Fahim sir from Thailand, Dr. Mumtaz Alam from Fiji Island, one faculty from Kuwait, and Ms. Sonali from Turkey. I must mention the names of my colleagues and coordinator of this international webinar, Professor Fazil Sharif and Dr. Reshma Patil, who made this event rememberable. I'm also thankful to my colleagues, Mrs. Shabana Mullah, Dr. Riyasat Pirzadeh, Professor Moeen, Professor Imran Mirza, and Professor Fahimuddin Ahmed for giving the helping hand to conduct this event and extending technical support for this entire webinar. I'm also very grateful to our principal, Professor Dr. Aftab Anwar Sheikh sir, and Dr. Nasreen Khan, HOD Department of Commerce, for their initiative and motivation for conducting this international webinar. A big thank to both of you. Last but very important, I am thankful to all the participants for their valuable time and inputs for this international webinar. Thank you, one and all. Thank you, Fazil sir.
Thank you so much, Akbar sir. Thank you so much. I request all the participants to kindly rise off from the chairs and seats for the Indian national anthem. And please make sure your mics are muted.
तब तुम मानो जागे सुनागे
Fazil sir.
Yes, sir.
Ask Manoj Kamath sir to talk about the what we are organizing on 11th of this May, another international seminar.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Manoj, sir, are you there?
Hi.
Yeah. Could you throw some light on the event that we're planning to have on the 11th of May?
Yes. In association with Pune College, what we are doing is we want to have one, we will call it as a faculty development program on these different issues on COVID, the aftermaths, and how well we are prepared for COVID. Now we are in the process of identifying some speakers, and then very soon, in next a day or two, we will send you the list of speakers, their probable topics, and then circulate it. And then let us see, try to take it to a different extent. I'm very happy that today's webinar had almost 98 participants, close to 100 participants. We'll try to increase the participation by a little bit. If possible, those of you who are from different institutes around the world, most of y'all can also be a part of this particular thing. Please write a mail or just write one, put a message to me or either to Anwar sir that you would like to participate and show, give us a letter of your intent so that we can incorporate the logos of your respective institutions on the certificate itself. So it will be a unique thing. Say, assume if there are, say, 5 to 10 institutes who come together and launch a program, the effect of that would be high. And then if it in from every institute, if there are 100 people, and if there are 10 institutes, we have 1,000 people here, plus 1,000 people from our friends. It will help us to go global. And the effect of this particular exercise will also have been very, very tremendous. So, of course, Pune College and Mallikarjun College in India, in Goa, will be the lead organizers. All of you who wish to be the part of it can also be the organizers for this. And then we can share a good session. If there are good number of speakers, we can spread that webinar over some 3-4 days also. Even if you have it for 7 days, maybe 1 hour every day or 40 minutes every day for 7 days, it still also makes a good difference. we can distribute that certificate. And in India, those who do this will also be eligible for their promotions for associate professorship. And you can claim that you have done an 8 days or 7 days, a week long faculty development program, or we will call it as a capacity development program. And this is an unique opportunity for all of us to come together. Just throw some suggestions in case you have.
Right. If anybody, any participant would like to have their college join hands with us, we would be more than welcoming to have you on board. And we look forward to have a greater, grander, and even a more better organized, because there's always room for improvement. So even a better seminar in the near future to come. That is probably on 11th of May is what you've decided. So with this, on this note, I think Anwar sir, we can conclude the session for today.
Thanks to Dr. Ripurin sir also, because the topic we have justified with that.
Right, sir. Thank you. Hello. And regarding one last notification regarding your certificate. Sir.
Thank you very much.
Okay, regarding the certificates, they will be dispatched within a couple of days. Some participants have been sending messages that we've received wrong certificate or corrupt file. So that was a trial. There is no certificate in that. So your certificates will actually come within some time. Latest by tomorrow, you should have your certificate. If in case you do not get your certificate, you have the WhatsApp group. You please feel free to contact us over there and we will take care of it. All right. Thank you. Thank you so much, everybody. Thank you all the participants. It was wonderful hosting you all. Thank you so much. End meeting.